Greetings. Thank you, brother, for your comment. Jesus, peace be upon him, was only sent to the lost sheep of Israel. Therefore, he did not come to all mankind. That is a great question, brother, and the answer demonstrates the consistency of the message of the prophets of the Bible. First, let's just establish that Jesus really did say this about himself. Matthew 15:21. Jesus went away from there and withdrew into the district of Tyre and Sidon. And a Canaanite woman from that region came out and began to cry out, saying, "Have mercy on me, Lord, Son of David. My daughter is cruelly demon-possessed." So this woman was a Canaanite and not a Jew. But she believed Jesus could deliver her daughter from a demon. But he did not answer her a word. And his disciples came and implored him, saying, "Send her away, because she keeps shouting at us." But he answered and said, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." God sent his messengers to his people, Israel. One reason was to call the lost, or the sinners, back to repentance, back to following God. Because Yahweh God loves the lost before we can love him. But one reason Jesus came was to fulfill a promise by God to send a prophet to Israel. We'll get to that in a moment. But she came and began to bow down before him, saying, "Lord, help me." She bowed down to Jesus, meaning she worshiped Jesus. And Jesus did not yell or say, "Stop!" But Jesus did finally speak to her. And he answered and said, "It is not good to take the children's bread and throw it to the dogs." But she said, "Yes, Lord, but even the dogs feed from the crumbs which fall from the master's table." She was not insulted by being referred to as a dog. In fact, she called him Lord and compared him to being her master. Then Jesus said to her, "O woman, your faith is great. It shall be done for you as you wish." And her daughter was healed at once. So let this sink in, brother. Even though Jesus was only sent to Israel, Jesus healed this woman's daughter because of this woman's faith in Jesus. Jesus healed or answered the request of someone who was not a Jew. So did Jesus say, "I was only sent to Israel"? Absolutely. Without question or argument, Jesus, as the prophet of Deuteronomy 18, was sent to Israel. But that is not the whole answer, and does not represent or respect the whole truth. The prophets said many things which all come into play to understand the answer, brother. I have made mention of the prophet of Deuteronomy 18. Prophet Moses said that God would send a prophet to Israel. Deuteronomy 18:15. This is Moses speaking to Israel. "The Lord your God will raise up for you a prophet like me from among you, from your countrymen. You shall listen to him." God also said that he would send a prophet to Israel. Deuteronomy 18:18. "I will raise up a prophet from among their countrymen like you, and I will put my words in his mouth, and he shall speak to them all that I command him." Prophet Moses further even explains what he and God meant when they said, "like Moses." Deuteronomy 34:10. "Since that time, no prophet has risen in Israel like Moses, whom the Lord knew face to face, for all the signs and wonders which the Lord sent him to perform in the land of Egypt against Pharaoh, all his servants, and all his land. The Word of God clarifies that like Moses means the prophet would, number one, know God face to face, number two, so he could work signs and wonders like Moses. Notice, brother, the description of the prophet being in Israel is repeated here. So whoever this future prophet would be, he would be sent to Israel, meaning he would have to go to Israel and speak the word of God's message to Israel. Does it make sense, brother, that when this prophet eventually came, he, whoever he might be, would probably say, God sent me to Israel? In fact, brother, it should make perfect sense that the prophet would describe himself this way. I was sent to Israel, or to the children of Israel. And indeed, this is what Jesus said. Jesus, being the prophet, foretold in Deuteronomy 18. But the plan of God revealed by the prophets has many more details than that alone, brother. The prophets revealed that God would make another new covenant with Israel. Jeremiah 31:31. Behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah. Verse 33, but this is the covenant which I will make with the house of Israel after those days, declares the Lord. I will put my law within them, and on their heart I will write it, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. This is repeated in the New Testament. Hebrews 8:8. But when God found fault with the people, he said, behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah. This is the covenant I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will put my laws in their minds and inscribe them on their hearts, and I will be their God, and they will be my people. Were the Jews looking for this new covenant? Malachi 3:1. See, I am going to send my messenger, and he will clear the way before me. Then the Lord you seek will suddenly come to his temple, the messenger of the covenant you desire. See, he is coming, says the Lord of hosts. Yes, the Jews desired and wanted this new covenant. And when Jesus came, did he claim he was bringing this new covenant? Yes, he did. Luke 22:20. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is poured out for you. The old covenant was marked by circumcision of the flesh. I'm quite sure you know what this means, and that Islam requires circumcision of the flesh. But the prophets also foretold of circumcision of the heart. Deuteronomy 36. Moreover, the Lord your God will circumcise your heart and the heart of your descendants, to love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul, so that you may live. Jeremiah 4:4. Circumcise yourselves to the Lord and remove the foreskins of your heart, men of Judah and inhabitants of Jerusalem, or else my wrath will go forth like fire and burn with none to quench it, because of the evil of your deeds. Romans 2:29. No, a man is a Jew because he is one inwardly, and circumcision is a matter of the heart by the Spirit, not by the written code. Such a man's praise does not come from men, but from God. This circumcision of the heart is the result of the new covenant that God would establish. Remember, this is God's plan revealed by the prophets. And the gospel, the Injil, the good news, is that Jesus came to bring or make this new covenant. The prophets revealed that God would come to his temple as a messenger or a prophet of the covenant the Jews desired. Malachi 3:1, "See, I am going to send my messenger, and he will clear the way or prepare the way before me. Then the Lord you seek will suddenly come to his temple, the messenger or prophet of the covenant you desire. See, he is coming, says Yahweh of hosts." And we know the messenger sent to announce God coming to his temple is prophet Yahya, or John the Baptist. Isaiah 40 verse 3, "The voice of him that cries in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of Yahweh, make straight in the desert a highway for our God." Matthew 3:3, "This," speaking of John the Baptist, "is he who was spoken of through the prophet Isaiah, a voice of one calling in the wilderness, prepare the way for the Lord, make straight paths for him." John 1:23, "John replied in the words of Isaiah the prophet, I am a voice of one calling in the wilderness, make straight the way for the Lord." Jesus, peace be upon him, was only sent to the lost sheep of Israel, therefore he did not come to all mankind. The implication of the conclusion is incorrect because of confusion surrounding the word "to," brother. Jesus was sent to Israel, but Jesus was sacrificed for the entire world. John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that he gave the only begotten Son, so that everyone believing in him should not perish, but should have eternal life." God's love and God's plan was for the whole world, not just for the Jewish people. But the way God accomplished his plan involved sending Jesus to Israel. This is because God's plan was to bless the whole world through Abraham. Galatians 3:8. "What's more, the scriptures looked forward to this time when God would declare the Gentiles to be righteous because of their faith. God proclaimed this good news to Abraham long ago when he said, all nations will be blessed through you." And where in the scriptures, where in the message of the prophets did God reveal this plan? Genesis 12:3, "And I will bless those who bless you, and the one who curses you I will curse, and in you all the families of the earth will be blessed." Genesis 18:18, "Since Abraham will surely become a great and mighty nation, and in him all the nations of the world will be blessed." Genesis 26:4, "I will multiply your descendants as the stars of heaven, and will give your descendants all these lands, and by your descendants all the nations of the earth shall be blessed." Jeremiah 4:2, "And you will swear as the Lord lives, in truth, in justice, and in righteousness. Then the nations will bless themselves in him, and in him they will glory." Was Jesus sent only to the people of Israel, who Jesus called lost sheep? Yes, when God sent Jesus, it was only to the nation of Israel. But it was to accomplish the plan of God. And the plan of God, revealed by the prophets, was for the whole world. I pray that God would grant you to desire truth and understanding, and that Yahweh God would clear up your confusion between the words "to" and "for." May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.